Hello students, in the previous class you have learnt about pollination, types of pollination, then devices for self pollination and cross pollination, and the adaptation. In today's class you will learn about pollen pistil interaction. What is pollen pistil interaction? Landing of pollen on stigma and it interact with the pistil, a carpel, or the gynecium, that is known as pollen pistil interaction. Now, what are the events which takes place in pollen pistil interaction? Landing of pollen grains on stigma, then pollen tube grow through style and it reaches the ovule through the micropylar end. All these events together known as pollen pistil interaction. Now, when the pollen lands on the stigma has to recognize the pollen, whether it is compatible, then the stigma will allow to grow the pollen tube. If the pollen is incompatible or sterile pollen, then the stigma and the pistil will reject the pollen. It will not allow to grow the pollen tube. Then when the pollen tube grows through the style, the generative cell, already you have learnt, when the pollen matures, it has got two cells, vegetative and generative cell. The generative cell starts moving with the pollen tube when it grows through the style to reach the ovary part, and it enters into the embryo sac through micropylar end. When it grows, the generative cell divides and it gives rise to two male gametes. So when the pollen tube reaches the micropylar end, what are the apparatus which guides the pollen tube entry? Here, when the pollen tube reaches the micropylar end of the ovule or female gametophyte, it has two male gametes. The finger-like projection you can see here, these are filiform appendages. These are filiform appendages which directs the pollen tube to release the male gametes. Now, the pollen tube releases two male gametes. Here there are the two male gametes which are released in the synergids cytoplasm. This is synergids, and the nearby cell is, this is egg cell. So two male gametes are released in the synergid cytoplasm. Next, the one male gamete fuses with the egg nucleus. The other male gamete which fuses with the polar nuclei. Two male gametes are released by pollen tube to the ovule. So what will happen? One male gamete fuses with the egg nucleus and it forms zygote. That is known as syngamy. Simultaneously, another male gamete fuses with the polar nuclei. In the central cell, there are two nuclei which fuses with the another male gamete, the PE, and what is the primary endosperm nucleus is formed. This fusion is known as triple fusion. Why it is called triple fusion? Because male gamete one and polar nuclei, there are two nuclei, so together three nuclei fuses together, and the primary endosperm nucleus is triploid in nature, whereas zygote is diploid in nature. So syngamy, fusion of male and female gamete produces the zygote. This process is known as syngamy, and triple fusion takes place simultaneously in the embryo sac, or in the ovule. So that is why this is known as double fertilization or triple fusion. Two fertilization takes place simultaneously in the ovule or embryo sac. That is why this is known as double fertilization. What is the nature of this question? Is what is the ploidy of zygote? What is the ploidy of endosperm? What is the ploidy of nucellus? This question, these type of questions are frequently asked in CBSE board exam. So you should be familiar with that. When the zygote means diploid nature, endosperm is triploid nature, that is 3N. And if it is asked, male gametia, pollen grains, that is N, haploid in nature. Then primary endosperm nucleus, it is after fertilization, this will form endosperm. That is triploid in nature. The endosperm will be triploid in nature. After fertilization, the zygote will develop into embryo, that is diploid in nature. So now fertilization, you have learnt about that, the pollen pistil interaction, how the pollen tube grows and it releases the male gametes, and fusion of male and female gamete, that is zygote formation and endosperm formation. Another male nucleate fuses with the primary endosperm nucleus, that forms the after fertilization, that will form endosperm. In case the normally cell pollination, this thing normal pollen pistil reaction takes place in normal cell pollination and cross pollination. In case if you want to, your plant breeders want to attain their desirable characters, what will be the process, what they can do? And already you have learned in the previous chapter, your previous class, that is what are the uses of pollen. One use is, that is pollen banks, you have heard that we can store the pollen for future use. What are the future is in for the crop breeding programs, that is plant breeders use this stored pollen, that is desired characters which has the pollen, that can be used for future in the plant breeding programs. Suppose if the plant, particular plant, it gives high yield, yeah, another plant is tolerant to the disease, so the farmer, yeah, plant breeder want to get both the desired quality. So what is the method? Here is the method that is known as artificial hybridization. What is the method here? Artificial hybridization. Artificial hybridization is a method which is used for the plant breeders to get the desirable qualities. So what are the methods which are used for the artificial hybridization? This is one of the method commonly used in plant breeding programs. Here the desired, for example, if it is a bisexual flower, then the anther is removed before it dehydrates. That process, what you call it as, that is emasculation, that is known as emasculation, that is removal of anther from a bisexual flower before it matures, before it dehydrates. That process is known as emasculation. The anthers will be removed. Then what is the next process? To prevent landing of undesired pollen on the stigma, that flower, that flower has to be covered by paper bag. Then when the stigma attain maturity, then what can be done? That can, the desired pollen can be dusted on the stigma. So these are the two processes. One is emasculation, removal of anther from the bisexual flower, then it has to be bagged. That is the bagging technique. These two techniques are used in artificial hybridization to attain a desired characters. Then after the pistil matures, the pollen will be dusted on the stigma, then it is allowed to fertilize further. This will develop into a fruit. Okay.